First of all, I'd like to thank everyone for their kind and supportive words last weekend, and to apologize for missing the Saturday broadcast. Our pet dog, who was 14, reached the end of his life and crossed the Rainbow Bridge in my arms. He was a good dog, and I miss him. Our house is a much quieter place without his yelping barks. I have an episode in the works talking about the current state of affairs in gaming. I've been researching it for a while, and I hope to have the final product ready for Saturday's episode. There is a lot of ground to cover, though, so I may have to split the episode into parts to keep the length down to under 15 minutes. I'd also love to move on from the election. I'm sure that many others feel the same way, too. Unfortunately, in at least 3 or 4 states, the elections aren't exactly over. Why is this? When our society discusses issues politely, with each side seeking a peaceful resolution, everyone benefits. When the discussion is a highly polarized shouting match between people who just don't listen to each other, well, it's time for some roasted opinions. One of the greatest strengths in the American system is that so many offices are elected by the people. This provides a wonderful check on the abuse of power, as our officials ultimately must appeal to the voting public every few years in order to get and keep those government jobs. Bad leaders can be removed from office without the drama of a separate process like impeachment. However, Election Day can also be our greatest weakness when there are irregularities. And irregularities occur quite a bit when each of the 50 states sets its own election laws. Differences between how voting proceeds in California and Maine's voting procedures will leave voters in both states wondering how the other state manages to conduct an honest vote. Election Day was over a week ago. Are the results tallied? No. Just no. The votes are never tallied overnight, although the tallies begin as quickly as possible and are conducted as efficiently as can be managed. The Secretary of State for each individual state must certify the election results, and before those election results can be certified at the state levels, each commissioner in charge of the voting in each individual county must certify results of that county. Before that can happen, the precinct managers must report the results of counting in that precinct to the county commissioner. It's a lengthy process, and because of differences in how each state chooses to run their voting, those tallies can take more than just a few minutes. Arizona election law allows early voting by mail, a distinct convenience for rural voters who live in some counties that are larger than some other states. It can be a disadvantage, too, because hundreds of thousands of early ballots are dropped off at the voting precincts on Election Day. Even early ballots have to have a signature which must be verified against the one on file. And then the rosters from in-person voting must be compared to early balloting to check for double voting. Then, and only then, can ballots be tabulated. And on Election Day, there was a significant discrepancy. You see, early ballots from Maricopa and Pine counties, which had signatures that didn't match, were allowed to be cured within 5 days after the election by the voter. And the other 13 counties in Arizona do not permit this. So the Arizona courts had to decide what to do to cure this discrepancy between voting procedures. And they decided that all counties must allow the voters to cure their signatures. Hence, the final day for curing signature problems with ballots is today, November 14th. That significantly delayed the results of the election for Arizona's new U.S. Senator, who will replace Jeff Flake. And it's a close election. Florida elections are notorious for the problems which they face. First, there doesn't seem to be a law about ballot measures addressing only one issue at a time, so Florida voters get to up or down vote measures which combine unrelated issues. Amendment 9 from this year's ballot banned both offshore oil drilling and indoor vaping, for example. What exactly indoor vaping has to do with offshore oil drilling is beyond me. but I don't live in Florida. Florida also has a reputation for voter tally irregularities. In the 2000 election, Florida still used the so-called butterfly ballot, which left our entire country waiting around for hundreds of election workers to decide which Chad indicated a vote and which one didn't. Some counties in the panhandle allowed voters to cast their ballots by email this election, a clear violation of election law. This was done because of the storm damage from a hurricane which happened just before the election day. While I understand the sentiment, such changes must be approved before election day to be valid. Now those counties will have to go back and eliminate those votes from their tally. This year, it's also the provisional ballots in Florida which seem to be causing the most problems. Broward County especially seems to have a major problem with how they handle these provisional ballots. Not a procedural issue, a chain of custody issue. Under Florida laws, ballots must be maintained in a chain of positive custody in order to be valid, just like a chain of evidence. Yet thousands of ballots were discovered left behind in rental trucks, abandoned at voter precincts, and otherwise mishandled. Then there's the fact that provisional ballots in Broward County break overwhelmingly for the Democrat Party, and an already close race will become closer still, perhaps even close enough to trigger a mandatory machine recount. Still more ballots which turn up during the machine recount can narrow the margin of victory enough to trigger a hand recount of every single ballot. And these all cause delays. To be blunt, there's some shady stuff happening in Broward County, Florida, and this isn't the only county which seems to have these problems. In the Georgia gubernatorial race, the current Secretary of State for Georgia is one of the candidates. Now, a wise person in that situation would recuse him or herself in time to avoid influencing the results, in order to avoid the appearance of impropriety. Perhaps Georgia should stop voting for their chief elections official and start appointing the Secretary of State to avoid such problems. But I don't live in Georgia either, so I really don't have a say in how Georgians choose their Secretary of State. It's a pretty close race for governor in Georgia, and the Democrat candidate refuses to concede the election. That's fine. A losing candidate doesn't have to concede for the results to be determined. However, the GOP candidate made some decisions before the election on how the voting would be handled, and gave the Democrat candidate everything she needed to dispute the results of the election. If the party affiliations were reversed, I would have to say exactly the same thing right now. You idiot! You've tainted the results of the election and your chances in every future election. How do you expect people to think you smart enough and honest enough to run the state if you can't figure out that you're going to have a negative impact on the results of the election? Maine looks like it's headed for controversy too, thanks to the adoption of the ranked preference ballot. Voters don't just pick one candidate for office, they rank all of the candidates in order of preference. So when the votes are tallied, if no one has a mathematical majority, the bottom finishing candidates are tossed out of the count and their votes are redistributed to the second choice for the voters. This process is repeated until a candidate has a mathematical majority. On one hand, it sounds good because it reduces the chances of a runoff election in a state that requires an absolute majority. On the other hand, the more spots on a ballot to be marked, the greater the chance that a ballot could be spoiled by stray marks or double voting. So here we are, over a week after the elections, and we still don't know the final makeup of the U.S. Congress. We won't know anytime soon either, as many of these problems are headed for the courts. I remember the presidential election in 2000, folks. Take off your shoes and get comfortable. We're going to be waiting for a while. Now that's just my opinion. Comment below to share yours. If you like this video, check out my playlists. Check out these channels I have subscribed for more great content. New episodes are coming, so subscribe and ring the bell.